I think that mother fostered family closeness. And I think that that Athena and Marie fostered it too.
The only thing that comes to my mind is she was so satisfied with the way her family was going, her immediate family.
She was very nice to Avis and Irene. And Irene, to her credit, accepted the Macedonian way of life, even though it was alien to her.
And here she gets into this Macedonian family who are, bickering, loud. They never, you know, they let their feelings hang out, and then on the other hand, they hug each other, and that was it. She was very happy when I got married. She was happy when my brothers got married. She taught your mother the Macedonian cooking, which your mother took to beautifully. And as a matter of fact, so did Avis. They both learned to cook the things that mother cooked. And I think both Greg and Alex appreciated that. It was important to them to see that everybody did well. And the way to see that everybody did well was to be part of the larger family. And of course, for the kids, it was wonderful. You had a loving family around you. I knew that if anything happened to my parents, that somebody else would take over. And I think everybody else probably knew that, too. They didn't think of it. You know, it was never something that we talked about. But we all knew each other so well, we could drop in and it didn't matter. Mary and I, for instance, used to ride our bikes all the way from our house in Richfield to Auntie Marie's house near Lake of the Isles. And we would just pop over there just to say hi. And everybody said, great, you know, it didn't matter what time of the day it was just, we would pop over. And I think that's a really nice feeling, you know, that you can do that kind of thing. You can't do it with very many people.
We also had an understanding of one another and actually liked one another. And I think friendship relationships as well as the blood revel relationships, I think were a significant part of togetherness. Family, her children, and all of the rest of us, not necessarily just children, but she had such a good opinion of and was so pleased that I think it was the greatest pleasure in her life is to see this growth of young people that she loved so much. The first was Chris, and she just loved to have Chris in the house or wherever. And that's all she ever thought about as to how great it was with these kids.
It's really what you would expect. She was a very loving grandmother and just took the children to heart. The big difference was in my father, who mellowed and showed his soft side.
And my impression of all the grandchildren, including my own kids, is that they thought she was absolutely unique, that she was a very unusual grandmother.
That was her life. That was her accomplishment and what she lived for. Plus, it was intrinsic. It was inbred. The families in Macedonia were very close. They lived in close quarters, and they depended on each other.
Part of our family gatherings had to do with all the fun that we had as cousins. My brother Greg would make up ghost stories, and he'd have all of the kids around him, you know, just listening in awe to all of these ghost stories. Then we would play Oochie Goochie Gumdrop, which was really, we'd run around, you know. It was like a game of tag, but you had the gumdrop, and you'd be saying Oochie Goochie Gumdrop, and if you found the gumdrop, you'd shout out, Gumdrop, Gumdrop. It was the dumbest thing, but we had so much fun. And he would gather the kids around just like the Pied Piper. And I will always remember that. And I know that other cousins remember that too. We had a wonderful time together. It was very free and easy. And I think that's part of why it was fun to be together.